because of the tariffs, we're in an incredible negotiating position, and we happen to be taking in billions and billions and billions of dollars.
Starting today, a new wave of tariffs set to take effect. The U.S. slapping 15% tariffs on $112 billion worth of goods coming from China. These include clothing, electronics, as well as meat and dairy. So, what does this mean for your wallet? Let's bring in former chief economist for the U.S. International Trade Commission and your shot of financial Red Bull in the morning, Peter Morici. Peter, always great to have you here. How are these tariffs going to impact the average American?
Not as much as the critics say. We're certainly not going to be paying $17 billion more for the stuff that we buy. The reason is the Chinese yuan has gone down. That gives all importers of every kind on all products a discount. The other thing is that importers have opportunities to find suppliers outside of China. And they do that. In turn, Chinese suppliers cut prices, and consumers can make substitutes. You don't like the TV set from China because it's 15% more or 10% more, you buy one from Taiwan or Vietnam. This is basic excise tax shifting. We teach it about the fourth or fifth week of Principles of Economics. And when the critics on the left say, you're going to bear all the taxes, they basically have forgotten, those economists, what they learn in school very conveniently. It's the flip of them saying increasing the minimum wage would have no effect at all.
Okay, let me ask you this, though. There's a report out that J.P. Morgan is saying this is going to cost the average American family $1,000. Do you agree with that? $1,000 per year, I should say.
That's a big number, and I really doubt it. I think those guys need to be defrocked. You should basically go in there and do a blind poll. Just hit a computer key. Who did you vote for last time, Trump or Clinton?
You think they're doing this on the coasts? The New York, California research arm of
J.P. Morgan?
That's
exactly what's been going on. I did a hit over with National Public Radio, where a professor at a small college said consumers pay 100% of the tax. I'd like to know what she's teaching in Principles of Economics. It's in like Chapter 7, every one of the books that we show. If you put an excise tax on something, the producers pay part of it, the consumers pay part of it. In this case, the producers are really being hit because in addition to the usual supply and demand dynamics, the value of the yuan has gone down. We get a discount on everything,
right?
Not just $112 billion, but everything for the falling yuan.
Professor, even though you may disagree with some people as to the degree of what is going to be happening to the average American family, you acknowledge that something is going to be happening. In the long run, is it going to be worth it?
Absolutely. We don't want to be in tutelage to the Chinese. We don't want to be their servants. They are using these trade tactics to steal our technology, to erode our competitive advantage. They've been very clear. They want to be globally dominant, establish an empire in which we are all supplicants to them. This is about American freedom. To me, that is much more important than the price of a TV set or a love seat.
Yes or no answer in the 10 seconds we have remaining. Do you see a compromise coming up anytime soon between the U.S. and China?
I think we're headed for a stalemate, and I think we have to start looking at Plan B, and that is basically redirecting the supply chain to Southeast Asia. There's no reason to believe that we need to buy everything from China.
Vietnam, Pete's clapping. Peter Morici, your namesake, Pete Clappin, thank you so very much.